obliterate the competition was by competing. So Brad Pitt not only wants the job handed to him, he wants no competition. How dare they bring in competition for me? Well, who are you? You haven't done anything. And you want the job handed to you? What? With what? A guarantee? There are no guarantees. When you are in a world of performance, I don't care what it is. I don't care if it's quarterback, second baseman, goalie, talk show host, whatever. You are competing. The only time you're not competing is when they know everybody competes against you. Like you're Tom Brady. So the bottom line is, you're always competing. Your performance gets to a level where they know they don't have to worry about competing against you. Bradford's never gotten to that level, so Bradford, I can't expect them. They gave him the job. They said it's his job this year. What do you want? A lifetime guarantee? I mean, geez. You can't be in a sport like that and be a quarterback and be afraid of competition. You know what you have to say? Come take my job. If you're good enough. What do you mean you don't want to compete? You brought me in here. How dare you draft a quarterback? What have you ever accomplished? You're not, we paid you too much money. We're dumb enough to pay you too much money, but you don't deserve to have a job handed to you. What have you ever done? It's amazing. I mean, what is it? I can't understand. I'd be worried. If I'm the Eagles, I'd trade him. I'm afraid a guy like that doesn't even want to compete against anybody. Sonny in Malvern. What's up, Sonny?
Hey, Mike. With Don Cruz and Kasich teaming up to try to stop Trump, I can open the door, unfortunately, to Hillary Trump's country. And then we're all in trouble.
Listen. One step at a time. Just take the primary first. Just take the nomination first. Get the nomination locked up. Then get, we'll worry about the general. First things first.
What's going on, dude?
The nomination is not locked up yet on either side. So let's just deal with that right now. Mike and Tom's River, what's up, Mike?
Hey, Mike, how's it going?
Good, what's happening?
Nothing much. I wanted to get your thoughts on how concerned should Mets fans be with DeGrom's velocity and Harvey's velocity down, and how much does it have to do with them pitching most innings of their career last year?
I think it's something that bears watching and will become a bigger issue, not a smaller one, if it continues. Now, it's not enough innings this year. DeGrom was in and out of the lineup because of the baby and because of his injury. Harvey also was sick a little bit in spring training, so let's give them both a little bit of a pass on that. But you're dead on. We have not seen any real velocity or any nasty stuff out of DeGrom or Harvey this spring. And less out of Harvey. But neither one of them is up there in the 90s. Neither one of them is giving you the crackling stuff they gave you last year. Now, last year, I'd say Harvey, on one or two occasions, approached his best of the year before. I don't think he ever sustained it. I think he touched on it. I think in the middle of the game that he wound up going out in the ninth inning, his last performance, I thought in that game, and I have a good seat for that and to judge the pitcher. I thought he had as good a stuff as he had the year before in that game for about 4 innings. They couldn't touch him, and that's a good lineup, and they couldn't touch him.
Mr. Opponent, where are you?
I think, guys, it bears watching that neither one of them is pitching with the same stuff that they had last year. Is the innings an issue? Is there any other issues? We need to see that. And Harvey goes around tomorrow night, another example of that. And let's see where they are in a couple of weeks, Paul. But I think you brought up the next one.
Let's try this again.
What's up, Mike? Hi, Mike. Just wanted your opinion. Do you think at this point in his career, we can say LeBron is the greatest forward who's ever played the game?
Not a forward, but I mean, he doesn't really have a position. But, to me, there's three centers and he and Jordan. I mean, when I look at it, there's three centers and he and Jordan. I don't think you categorize LeBron as having a position. He doesn't out of position. You know, sometimes he plays, in essence, what's the four for them. Sometimes he plays the point for them. So, I mean, it really, he can guard anybody on the floor. He can play any position on the floor. So he's multi-positional. So I really don't think there's been a player like that because of his size and his passing ability and his prowess. I don't think there's anybody who's played that like that, where he played. You know, Jordan was a bona fide two. That's what he was. He was a pure, pure two. Kobe was pure two. You know, Magic Johnson played multiple positions. But LeBron plays basically almost plays every position on the floor. Gary in Connecticut, what's up, Gary?
Mike, how you doing?
Good.
I know it's early in the year, but I'm calling about how stupid the All-Star game is. It bothers me so much that MLB tries to cram it down our throat and make it important, where they put home field advantage on the outcome. And
I have yelled about that.
There we go.
Instituted. Strong and I had a fight about it. I went at on it the day it was instituted. I thought it was the most ridiculous thing. First of all, I've never been an All-Star guy. Secondly, I thought it would not help the All-Star game in any way, and it hasn't ratings-wise. And I thought it was the dumbest thing ever. One of the dumbest moves any league has ever made. And the first thing Manfred should do is remove that the home field in the World Series has anything to do with the All-Star game. He should completely take that rule and end it. It's one of the worst rules ever instituted. It was a rash judgment after they played that All-Star game to a tie and everybody went crazy. The All-Star game has no impact anymore. You see these guys every day. Every one of their at-bats is video. You can watch on MLB at-bat every at-bat these guys play in the year. You see them all play every day. There's no allure to the All-Star game anymore. They change.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, a matchup in the AFC South, as we join you from Everbank Stadium.
Bill, we've got a couple of the best tight ends in the game on each sideline today.
All right, 7-1 going into the second half of the season. Let's keep that bad boy up.
Tremendous blockers for the running game. They got the speed to go down the field, and they got feet, Jim. You know, those quick feet, so even when they run those short routes, if there's man-to-man coverage, they're quick enough and shifty enough to still get away from the defense.
Let's go, Blake, with that arm strength. Keenan Allen goes boom. You hope so.
The wide receiver shifting around in motion.
What the?
What was that, a false start?
Oh, yeah, that was. That was easy to see. Even with your bad eyes, as you get older, you can see that he moved before the snap of the ball.
Three,
Wow. Ball starting like crazy. What are you doing, buddy? Snap the ball. You've gotten three straight false start penalties. Hard counting. Snap the ball on one.
Backs to the wall for the offense. Here comes the wide receiver in motion. We'll send it back to the quarterback out of the gun. It's Jalen Strong with the catch.
That's going to come back.
Maybe they can turn that fumble recovery into points here in the first quarter, Phil.
I'd be surprised if they don't, Jim. You know, the moment.
We have a review coming from the booth. Was the knee down, Phil, or was it a fumble first?
I think what we need to do here, let's stop it when the knee hits the ground. And once we stop it, let's look at the football. Does he have possession of it completely at that time? If he does, then it's going to be down. The runner will be down before the fumble occurs.
Looks like a false start penalty.
I guess he wants to see how many false start penalties that one left tackle can get.
Third down after the penalty. The Jaguars with two extra defensive backs in the dime.
Okay.
That's going to bring up fourth down. So this offense fails to move the chains here on third down, and that's an early win for this defensive team.
It was. Good job by the defense. I like what they did. Now can the offense come on the field and get involved and make something happen and get some emotion on that sideline for the football team?
Set up return. Here we go. And they get to him at the 45.
Jaguars know there's three parts to every football game. Offense, defense, and special teams. What a play for the special teams here. Good punt return, good blocking, they get it done. D-line is shifting inside. They're pinching. I think they're expecting to run up the middle.
Over to Thomas.
Way too much room for him to cover.
The defensive line saw something the offense is doing. Look at them all shifting to the right.
Portal is going to take the snap from the shotgun and a gain of four.
Okay, good with them so far.
Today. Here's how the Texans defense, a defense that's been a porous defense when it comes to stopping the run. They have got to figure out a way to stop the running attack. This is third down.
and don't run it.
Let's go, Yeldon.
No one's going to get him now. Next third quarter, the defensive line. You better get it.
What's going on, dude?
Trying to keep him out of the end zone. Defense is crowding the line of scrimmage. They're trying to confuse the quarterback. First and goal. And Ivory's taking the handoff. And Navarro Bowman brings him down. Ivory's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain. Breaking huddle at the four.
I am fine and dandy, just relaxing a little bit this afternoon.
Second and goal from the four.
All right, good start.
He's in for the touchdown. They built up a nice lead. We're still only midway through the first quarter.
It is a good lead midway in the first quarter, and while the offense is hot, the quarterback, everybody playing well right now, and I don't know what's going to stop them.
The Jaguars ready to put the football down the field. And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19.
Defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
He's tackled at the 30. That's reception number 2 for him. First down here. They're back at the line after that catch for a first.
All right, come on, defense. That's what I like to see, Dante Fowler. When I play wide nine to try to run outside, hold that edge if you're a good block shutter, please.
You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for a big play, what happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
And here we have second down.
Okay.
Just a few yards. Here's the Texans lineup. Their passing numbers on the year are just dreadful. Third down, following the run. The Texans come to the line. First down marker at the 40.
Let's go, Dante Fowler. Beautiful throw. beautiful high throw right between the dropping back backer and the corner, and the perfectly thrown comeback route. Defensive line. Defensive line showing up.
Here's the Jaguars, defensive lineup. One of the best teams in the league this year against the post.
What the YO, this pleasure. Lots of false start penalties.
Third down after the penalty. The Texans will set up. The 28 is the first down line.
Okay.
I know it looks easy, but it's not. But a nice throw on the slant route. Slant route means you're slanting towards the inside. Good throw and catch.
Press coverage all the way.
The hell is this?
On offense here to start the second quarter.
That was scary. Big jumble of mess there. That's why I say the field is scaled too small. You have way too much of that. Guys getting each other's way in their routes. The spacing is bad on these route combinations, and the field is, I don't believe, scaled wide enough.
Still fired in there. Nice throw right on target by the QB.
third down on the way. The Jaguars defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Good job.
The defense did a very good job there on third and long. They got the incomplete pass, but it's the work they did on first and second down. They made it tough on the offense, so third and long, everything goes to the advantage of the defense.
We'll see what he can do here. That picks up 11. The Jaguars offense coming back onto the field. It was a good drive for them last time they had it. All the way down to the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah, you know, in this game, Jim, it's all about momentum. And when you feel you got the momentum on your side, you got to take advantage of it. So now I think it's up to the offensive coordinator to call the right play.
Bortles will be taking this snap out of the pistol.
Ah, that's a light box. That's run time. I better get forward progress. Fine. Don't.
That's just a bad job by the offensive line.
Loss of two on that play. This will be a second down. We'll go ground.
If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
After that run, third and eight for the offense.
Jim, look at that. The defensive line all shut down inside. They're expecting a run right up the middle.
From the gun. Has his target. And he's taken down until he picks up.
All right, we're starting out pretty nice.
Are leading in this one, and a lot of that goes back to the play of this quarterback, Phil. Bortles been on the mark to this point.
He has. He's one of the better throwers in the NFL. Give him time like he's had here so far today, he is going to put it right on target.
First down at the 49. Is on the move. Gives himself up.
Didn't like what I saw there.
Hits at all costs. Good job that time by the quarterback sliding before he takes the hit.
The 43-yard line. Bortles ready for the snap. Empty backfield. Second down and five. He'll throw it over the middle.
Ooh, good play.
When you see a receiver drop a pass, it does go through the quarterback's mind. Well, he's a good player, and I want to keep his confidence level up, and I want to keep him into the game. So when you get a chance, you throw him another football so he can make that catch and get right back in with it.
The offense now needs to pick up the first here on third down after that incompletion. The Jaguars will line up the first down marker right at the 39-yard line. Full start on
wow.
Offense.
We'll set the full back. Start penalties as far as I can see today. I get hit by one that time. Shot I had at that.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
And And so now they'll bring out Malone to punt. That beautifully executed.
Nice.
Defense forcing the opposition to start the next drive inside the 10. The Texans didn't get much out of that last drive, so now here they come again on offense. I'm sure they're going to be a little bit more of an urgency to the offense this time.
Well, I'll just say this to you, Jim Nance. I sure hope so. After that last drive, that was just too generic. Wasn't very well thought out, and they've got to change what they're doing.
Want to tackle, please, guys?
That's a little threat, though, don't you?
Well, yeah, the defense did its job, but that was pretty easy.
Now second down and 5 after running it on first down. Set up screen. Pass is targeted.
Thank you. Jeez.
The Texans understand. Just get whatever yards you can every time you run a play. That's what they do that time. It's a short completion. But look at what position it puts them here in on third down. This is something they can handle.
Third down after the completion. Two tight ends on the field here. Here's the handoff.
Thank you. Good job. It's always a nice thing when corners play for us. I'm a fan of it, Footy, believe me.
Good job by the defense.
Well, much a different world. This is CFM. An online CFM is a different ball game. And much you're dealing with supermen, remember. In CFM, we're dealing with regular dudes.
Pressure the quarterback on this play.
And we've reached the 2-minute warning.
In Mutt? Yeah, I am actually. Not in this game, though. I'm running 4-3 with the Jags.
Second down coming up.
I used the Ravens 3-4 playbook in Mutt.
Third and short following the completion.
Look out here. They're going to blitz. They're all packing the line of scrimmage.
Justin Blackmon.
Don't fumble.
Blackmon tackled down at the 15.
You know, throw the football like that down the field, you look on the offensive side, and you've got that defense guessing.
Bortles completion percentage, 80% on the day. First down at the 15.
The offense, they pick up a first down inside the 20-yard line. Now we'll see if they can punch it in and get 7 points.
Just 4 yards away from the end zone.
Oh, you see the linebackers moving around. I think they're trying to confuse the offensive line.
First and goal from the 4.
Oh, Blake? Let's go, Blake!
My goodness, Phil. Halftime can't get here soon enough as it's blowout city.
It is. I know you can't wait for halftime because you scarfed down food at halftime like you haven't eaten in a week. So we don't want to keep you from that. But this game, oh my gosh, it's been lopsided, hasn't it? And you're right, the team that's losing, they can't wait to get to the locker room.
Just past the 20, we'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Texans offense is on the field, hoping to erase the memory of their last drive, which was completely unproductive, a quick three and out.
Yeah, it was. I don't know if they can erase this defense. This defense is pretty good. We saw that in the last drive, and they got good players, and they're pretty excited, so this is going to be tough on the offense.
For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. The Texans from the 22, running right through the trenches, and he's tackled at the 30-yard line.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job on the offensive line.
The Texans will take the snap from the 30. Look at that
concentration. Oh, just tackling. Thank you. All right, good half, good half. Perfect half, really.
Time to get some backups, some playing time, and keep your starters healthy.
But just because I scored 28 points in one half doesn't mean that he can't. That's how I view these kind of things.
The second half kickoff is a comeback in the cards in this one-sided affair. Gets out past the 20 and
Cleveland in the National League. I picked the Mets in Washington.
What we got going on here? QB change, maybe?
So you think Houston's totally out of it?
No. I just picked Texas and I didn't pick a wild card out of that division. I think Houston's got a chance. I wouldn't put them out of it, no. I think they're in. I picked Toronto in the World Series and the Mets. Toronto Mets World Series, what? Bill in Connecticut. What's up, Bill?
Hey, Mike, good afternoon.
What's happening?
Mike, going back to Reggie Jackson,
yes.
Didn't he miss the first World Series that the A's got in with an injury?
No, he missed the A. He missed the...
He had a hamstring.
He had a hamstring pulled, yes. He missed the ALCS and he missed...
He missed the World Series.
He missed the ALCS and the World Series, I believe. He missed part of the ALCS and the World Series, correct, yes.
Right, so
yes.
He was really only in four. He had tremendous World Series numbers. But also in one of the ALCS with the Yankees, didn't Billy Martin bench him?
That was in the ALCS. But he had
game five, wasn't it?
But yeah, he against Paul Splitoff. He benched him against Paul Splitoff.
At the 24. The Texans offense trots out onto the field, looking to get into the end zone and see if they can turn the tide in this one, partner.
Well, the fact that they are losing this game so far, the sense of urgency is there on the offensive side. You know, you have many plays in that playbook. I think you need to try a few different ones here in the second half.
Approach the line and they're going with their jumbo package to the ground.
Let's go. Brandon Meebane.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all in the front that time and they only give up a short game.
Is a legal case. It's not a case based on
It's now second down. The Texans are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. Dropping back now into the shotgun. It's caught by Garrett Graham. That's a gain of six.
The Texans do a good job that time on second down. They don't force the football down the field. They throw it short. They pick up some solid yards to make it a good situation for them. Third and short. Just find ways to execute plays and get down there and score a touchdown.
First down, offense readying for the snap. First down here after the completion.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out, I think he's going to go down the field.
Let's go. Dante Fowler's come to play.
This might not be nice to say, but everyone's spot's kind of fun to watch the quarterback get sacked like that. Good job by the defensive end.
Looks like they're in press coverage here. The Texans will use a timeout here early in the second half.
No, I don't think he's running. Oh, he is. Jeez. Dante Fowler is just being an animal.
But the pass ball's incomplete. We still have more than a quarter to play here, Phil, but this defense shows no signs of wearing down.
I think we're surprised by this, really. We didn't expect them to just dominate all day long, and so far, it has been total domination.
One-on-one with a shot.
Got to give the secondary credit. This passing lead now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
Yeah.
with the incomplete pass. It's third down.
Yeah, you can't play 3-4 and ask a outside backer to cover that man-to-man. That ain't gonna happen.
Be decisive over there in the sideline. Do what's best for your football team. Keep getting those first downs and letting that clock just keep running. We got a big lead here in the second half. Don't take any chances.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Bortles going to take it from the gun. Connects with Thomas.
It's all clicking.
The Jaguars have created chances for themselves in the passing attack today. Bortles had a huge performance in this one.
When you talk about creating opportunities, that's where you have to give credit to the coaching staff. They have helped the players. The play designs have been good, and the players are taking advantage of it. Look out, the defense is showing a blitz here.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. And Ivory's going to take the handoff now.
Yeah, we need to be cute.
First down, bringing up second. The Texans will come out in the dive.
Oh, got it.
The blowout continues. Another touchdown. A little more salt in the wound with that touchdown, and we still got one more quarter to play.
Hey, look, this is professional football. Don't look for them just to slow down because they're nice.
All right, now I feel pretty safe.
They're going to play hard, so you better make your mind up to get out there and play hard, or you're just going to continue to get embarrassed.
Add the extra point. The kick is good. The Jaguars now getting ready to kick it away.
Wish I could bottle this. I played like crap the other day. Absolute crap.
Rather quietly, short of the 20.
During the season, Tom doesn't want to miss like the last four games of the season. If it comes down then, so that's the question. When do you do that? So to me, just take your medicine now. 3 o'clock, here's the make man. WFAN-FM.
It is official. A Texas grand jury has indicted ex-Browns QB Johnny Manziel on an assault charge after his ex-girlfriend accused him of domestic violence. NBA coach of the year, and that goes to Golden State, Steve Kerr. You can help support cancer research and prevention by joining WFAN's Ann Ligori at the 18th annual Ann Ligori Foundation Charity Golf Classic Monday, May 23rd at the prestigious Friars Head on the east end of Long Island. Detail and AnnLigori.com. 60 degrees, skies are mostly sunny. And that's what's happening. This is John Minko with 2020 Sports on WFAN Sports Radio 66 FM at 101.9. Flagship station for Boomer and Cart morning 6 until 10. Frances on the Fan afternoon 1 until 6:30.
Are you getting enough out of your daily probiotics? With GNC, you will. Thanks to America's fastest growing probiotic brand. Why is it number one? Maybe because GNC has guaranteed potency through its fresh buy date. 250% more live and active cultures compared to leading brands. And no need for...
Where'd he go?
Is best for you? Stop into your local GNC and talk with our experts. Just ask. We make it simple. GNC. See store for details. Sometimes diabetes can feel more like don't-a-bees. Don't do this, don't forget that. But with a little help from Walgreens, diabetes won't slow you down. Stop by to get expert pharmacy advice 24/7 and savings on medications and supplies. You can even get rewarded for healthy behaviors like logging your glucose. Walgreens is just what you need to do more with diabetes. Walgreens, at the corner of Happy and Healthy. Invitations apply for full program terms and conditions. Visit walgreens.com/healthychoices.
Radio's best personality, Kevin and Bean shows.
Got Shannon in the morning.
Your favorite music from the biggest stars.
Hey guys, I'm Iggy Azalea.
I'm Phil McGraw. Radio.com has the latest in music news, on-demand shows, and is the destination for CBS events and concerts.
Hey, CBS, Greg, good
to music, news, sports, and interactive content.
Radio.com.
I took tobacco for 18 years, and now...
Came on.
They got to change the tempo of this game.
What is this dude doing?
Yes, you do. You have to make a lot of picks, as a matter of fact.
Where'd he go?
Teach him the verb. The West Coast guys all do that. So Chase Daniels is here just
to get up and take the quarterback. Now, I can't imagine that conversation going on. So now the tough thing for Philadelphia is Sam Bradford's upset and knowing that if I stay with this team, the very first thing this team did to me was lie to me. That's something they're going to have to deal with.
Well, to me, though, Sam, listen, they paid you, and you have to go prove yourself, so go prove yourself. And you know what? If they put the two in ahead of you, it probably meant you didn't play well because they've already said it's your job, so you're going to have to play yourself out of the job anyway. So you're going to have to compete anyway.
You put me in line for the job that says, here, we'll give you $20 million. Let you compete for the job.
Absolutely.
If you don't play well, no harm, no foul.
Yeah, I mean, come on, Sam. And plus, you got paid $71 million on your first contract, and you didn't do anything during all years. So.
Yeah,
there we go. He's back.
The Texans step up to the line, employing now their jumbo package. First down at the 16. He runs with it right up the gut.
Brandon Mebane out there shooting gaps and getting off blocks.
That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9.
No, good play.
Well, that'll make you feel a little better. Finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half. When you're on the offensive side, don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. The Jaguars sat at the line. Dime package. First down at the 31.
Uh-oh.
After this play,
well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do is just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
Now, first and 10.
Ah, nice. Good one, Robert. Wide 9 holes.
The NFL has a box over there somewhere in that play sheet for a third and long, and he wants to try to pick the play up for the first down with a throw down the field. It could be seams, double moves, but they have 4 or 5 of those types of plays to pick up third and long situations.
We're heading to the fourth quarter in what has been a completely one-sided affair. I'd ask you if a comeback is possible, but when it's this margin, Phil, I'm a realist.
You are a realist, Jim, and you know when you're behind, like you are a lot of times when we play golf on the 14th or 15th hole, you know it's over, but we finish it out, and you know what I'm saying here in this football game, they got to go ahead and finish this game out. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
The final quarter underway now with this snap. Is going to go for it. It's a two tight end formation. They'll run it here. Then on the tackle.
All you can do is your job.
All right, now no one get hurt, please.
The offense, picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. Hey, don't worry about the score right now. Just find ways to execute plays and get down there and score touchdowns.
the Texans from the 27. Running away from the pressure. No separation.
Run for your life.
Good job that time by the defense. They let the quarterback get outside the pocket, but they stay in place, they show their discipline, and there's nowhere to throw it. Line of scrimmage, the 27.
That's false start number 5,000.
But it looks like a false start. And now, after the penalty, it's second down and 15. The Jaguars go with the dime formation here on defense. Second and long. Looking across the middle,
tough break.
They bring him to the turf early in the fourth, and if there was ever a thought of a miracle comeback, that interception pretty much ended it. Yeah, you know, I'm not sure they ever thought that there could be a miracle comeback in this game. It's been bad all day long. I feel, you know, I actually feel bad for them throwing that interception because they just can't seem to do anything right on the offensive side. Look at the signals. The D line is all shifting down inside. They're expecting to run right up the middle. After the 2-yard carry, it sets up second.
I just want to get this game done with now. Just don't fumble and do him a cheapie. Don't get hurt either. Should probably take him out of the game and put Ivory in, really. Tackle him. Jeez.
It's out there. You've got to get over that middle block, and you've got to keep playing hard and press the football. That's the only way you can have success. That'll be second and four after the running play. The Jaguars lined up in the nickel. Quick drop back. The catch is made by Strong. He is brought down at the 49-yard line.
Well, that'll make you feel a little better, finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half, but you're on the offensive side. Don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later.
First down at the 49. He'll throw it over the middle. And pick up about four.
The defense, they have a lead here.
Tick-tock, tick-tock.
So they're willing to give up. Short pass completion, but good job by the offense.
Second down, even after the completion. The Jaguars, with two extra defensive backs in the dime, gets the handle here. That picks up 11.
Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do is just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
And the offense will call a timeout.
Coming to the line at the 34.
Okay, good play. I ran toward a tight end corner.
Is your job. That was a good job by the offense, picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. Hey, don't worry about the score right now. Just find ways to execute plays and get down there and score a touchdown.
Staying with the passing game on first down.
Oh. Just snap the ball, dude. He's getting called for false starts every time.
And that'll be a false start. That'll cost him five. Set up now at the 26. Second and long. We'll go ground. Brought down at the 20.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense. When you get down to the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play.
The Jaguars defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. They're setting up screen.
Yes. Get him on the ground, please. Jeez.
And that's going to bring us to fourth down.
Good job by the defense. Staying in the right spots. They give up the short pass. They make the tackle. And now we have fourth down coming out.
They bring back out the offense to go for it. The Texans need to get to the 11 to pick up a first down out of the shotgun.
Oh, my. That got through? Wow.
Down after a gain of 15.
Well, that'll make you feel a little better finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half, and you're on the offensive side. Don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Hand off made. Down's the one who brings them to the ground.
That's been an awful day. They're getting blown out, but they're down here near the goal line.
Trying to get that zero off the board.
That might make them feel a little bit better.
What a drive this has been. Second and goal from the two.
And he does.
That's the first time he's found the end zone on the ground this season. The Texans for the extra point. He made it. The Jags are ready to return the kick. He'll have a chance to take off.
All right, take a knee and get out of here.
To the 20, mark them down at the 19. The Jaguars can put this game away here. Just run out the clock here, Bill. It's been a blowout victory, and now all you're trying to do is not get anybody hurt.
That's right. Get this game over with. And in the NFL, you've got to treasure moments like this. To win easily, that doesn't happen often, so enjoy this victory.
Come on, big for the NFL. It kind of really is their springboard to the season. It kind of gets, it really does start the ball rolling. Free agency, but this now, all of a sudden, this really starts the ball. Now you have your team.
Takes the knee.
Now you
and now he's just getting the rest of your town and he'll play the defense again.
Somebody there you've noticed?
Yeah, I don't know if Hackenberg or Connor are going to find a way in the first round. Maybe someone does try to sneak into the back end of the first round to pick them up. They probably need to check around guys. I think Paxton Lynch, along with Dawson Lynch, are the solid first round guys.
Nothing like being a little greedy in this.
Alrighty.
As the win streak adds another victory to the column.
Oh, you're right, Jared. When you're talking about winning, everybody wants to be greedy. And there's a reason why they're winning. They're hitting more than the other team. They're hitting harder. They've wanted more. And a lot of times, will has a lot to do with the outcome of NFL games.
Well, let's bottle that one. Everything just went perfect that game. Absolutely perfect. I'll take it. I won't complain one bit.
Jim Nance saying so long for now.
Making every pick in the draft. Jim, I wonder how many picks out of two, how many picks in the draft? 234, is it? How many things he'll get right? Player, team, how many things he'll get right out of 234? I want to ask him that. We'll have a pool. How many he gets right out of 234?
Alrighty, folks. I am out of here. Thanks for viewing. Hope you guys enjoyed. I will talk to you all later.